Norman E. Borlaug was an agronomist, a humanitarian, and a Nobel laureate. He grew up on a farm in Iowa, studied plant pathology at the University of Minnesota, and continued his work in the fields of Mexico at the Cooperative Wheat Research Production Program. Borlaug's work was based in Mexico for the rest of his professional career. He bred wheat cultivars resistant to disease, including the dreaded stem rust fungus, and trained scientists and technicians. His team developed semi-dwarf, high-yielding, disease-resistant cultivars of wheat. These varieties greatly improved wheat production in Mexico, which relieved hunger and poverty for millions. In 1960, Norman Borlaug was part of a team sent by the United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization to survey wheat and barley across North Africa, the Middle East, and South Asia. Borlaug saw enormous potential for wheat production in countries with long agricultural histories and climatic conditions suitable for wheat production. In March of 1963, M.S. Swaminathan invited Borlaug to visit India again. Borlaug brought with him a wide range of dwarf wheat seed possessing the Norrin 10 dwarfing genes. He wanted to test these new varieties in the fields of India with the hope that they could lead to wheat production improvements similar to those in Mexico. There were significant political and bureaucratic obstacles to introducing new varieties of wheat to India, but Norman Borlaug overcame them all. Between 1965 and 1970, wheat yields in India nearly doubled. To this day, wheat yields per hectare have continued to increase. Because of these successes, Norman Borlaug is often credited with saving the lives of more than 1 billion people. The legacy of Dr. Norman Borlaug is largely unknown in the United States, but in India, he is a legendary figure, a symbol of humanitarianism and agricultural self-sufficiency. In 2012, representatives from the Borlaug Global Rust Initiative traveled to India to meet with farmers and scientists who worked personally with Dr. Borlaug. They told us their stories, their experiences, and how well they remember the father of the Green Revolution.
When I started agriculture in 1969, wheat yield per hectare was not more than 2 tons. Now it has gone to 45, 4 tons, more than 4.5 tons. This is only possible only because of the science, technology and research. And all these people who are contributing to it, tirelessly, all of their whole life. For me, Dr. Borlaug is a god. He has saved the world from starvation. Nobody has in this world has done this. I think if Dr. Borlaug and his all team of scientists wouldn't have been there, today we would have gone for the Third World War because of the starvation. That is my personal belief. I remember he came with the medal. So I asked Dr. Kole, what he is giving. I think Dr. Sanghvi was also there. He told me that the money which he has got from the Nobel Prize, he has made gold medal for all the scientists who has worked with him in the world. He is visiting all the wheat research center and he is giving them this medal as the contribution they have made to his research. And with their contribution, he has got the Nobel Prize. That moved me. That was his greatness, that when he got the Nobel Prize, he remembered all the scientists, a small one from Nifad. He remembered those scientists and he had said that he has also contributed to his Nobel Prize. That was his greatness.
हाँ वो तो बिल्कुल हार्ड थे उनके हाथ इसके ऊपर स्क्रैच थे ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा यील्ड कैसा मिलेगा इसके इसीलिए उनके साथ बातचीत की वही कि जिन्होंने हमारे महाराष्ट्र की उत्पादन क्षमता एवरेज 50 केजी थी लेकिन जब उन्होंने नई नई वैरायटी संकर वैरायटी भारत में दी तो छः क्विंटल एवरेज वैरायटी इनके करने से हो चुकी। मैंने तो कहा इस देश का वो गॉड था, पूरी वर्ल्ड का भी गॉड कहेंगे हम तो, नहीं तो आजकल लोग क्या खाते।
डॉक्टर नॉर्मन ई बोरलॉग, विच वी कॉल इट नाउ डॉक्टर बोरलॉग, विजिटेड दिस फार्म इन, आई फेकली रिमेंबर, इन 1970। ही केम हियर अबाउट सिक्स टाइम्स। सो वेन एवर यू नो, वेन एवर ही विल कम टू, डॉक्टर बोरलॉग कम टू इंडिया, हिज विजिट टू पंजाब एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी, वी कॉल इट PAU, is a must, because the wheat program was very strong here and farmers were they received the new varieties with open arms. He was jovial by nature, so our evening would always been colorful. Most important with Dr. Bolog was that he wanted to go to the farm. He wanted to meet the farm. All the time he said, go to the farm, let us see the farm. In that reference, whenever he visited Punjab Agricultural University, he came here, and it was my privilege that always in the afternoon, late afternoon, so we sit here, talk and learn so many things from him.
Dr. Bolog यहाँ पे आए थे 2005 में, तो उन्होंने यहाँ आने के बाद हमें बहुत मतलब प्यार से वो मिले, सभी फार्मर से उन्होंने बहुत प्यार से बातचीत की। तो उनको मिलने से पहले तो कोई ज़्यादा वो नहीं था हमें, लेकिन उनको मिलने के बाद हमें लगा कि शायद दुनिया के एक महानतम व्यक्ति से हम मिल रहे हैं, और ज़िंदगी में हमारे लिए शायद एक बहुत बड़ी उपलब्धि है, जिस उपलब्धि के लिए शायद बहुत से लोग तरसते हैं, लेकिन वो उपलब्धि हमें हासिल हुई है, ये शायद हमारी किस्मत में लिखा था। इससे पहले हमारे इंडिया में तकरीबन जो है ना वो लंबी वैरायटी होती थी, गेहूं की जो थी वो बहुत लंबी वैरायटी होती थी और वो गिर जाती थी, उनकी पैदावार बहुत कम थी और एक उनके अंदर रतुआ बहुत ज़्यादा आता था, तो इसलिए यहाँ जो था अनाज की पैदावार बहुत कम होती थी। भारतवर्ष के अंदर जो हरित क्रांति आई है उसमें डॉक्टर बोरलॉग का बहुत महान योगदान है, क्योंकि उन्होंने उसके उन वैरायटियों को थोड़ा चेंज करके जीन दूसरा डाल के उनके कद को जो है वो छोटा किया, और उस कद छोटा होने की वजह से वो जो वैरायटी हैं उनकी उत्पादन क्षमता जो है वो कई गुना ज़्यादा बढ़ गई। शुरू में थोड़ा ये लगता था कि भी शायद ये जो है ये जो दूसरे बीज आए हैं इनसे इतना उत्पादन नहीं होगा, या पता नहीं ये सही हैं या नहीं हैं, ये हमारी ज़मीन में ठीक बैठेंगे नहीं बैठेंगे, लेकिन उसके बाद फिर जब हमने थोड़ा थोड़ा लगाना शुरू किया तो उसके बाद हमारा विचार जो है वो पूरी तरह से चेंज हो गया, और हमें लगा कि मतलब जो डॉक्टर बोरलॉग कह रहे हैं वो बिल्कुल सही है। डॉक्टर बोरलॉग जो हैं वो मेरे जीवन में या एक किसान के जीवन में एक बहुत बड़ा महत्व रखते हैं, और मैं तो ये कहूँगा कि वो अपने आप में पूरी एक यूनिवर्सिटी हैं, और उनसे मतलब आदमी बहुत कुछ, उनके संपर्क में आने से ही बहुत कुछ सीख जाता है, और उनके संपर्क में आने से बहुत बड़ा प्रभाव किसान के ऊपर या जो भी उनसे मिलता है उसके ऊपर पड़ता है। मैं ये सोच सकता हूँ कि शायद भूखमरी के शिकार इंडिया के अंदर और दुनिया में दूसरी जगह भी बहुत से लोग भुखमरी का शिकार हो जाते, और आज जो रोटी हमें मिल रही है या जो हर आदमी को जो अनाज मिल रहा है वो शायद ना मिल पाता, जिसकी कल्पना करके भी जो है वो आदमी का शरीर को कांप उठता है।
बोरलॉग नेम हैज़ बिकम वेरी कॉमन इन विद द कॉमन पीपल, द फार्मर्स। ही रियली इज सिंसियर, ही वॉन्ट्स टू हेल्प द नेशंस वेयर प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द चहू ग्रो व्हीट, and they are short of this, and people are dying of hunger particular also. So he wanted to always talk about population. Whenever he lecture, he must say about the population. Who will feed them? And how can be they fed? That was his concern. That's why you go to him now, Punjab farmer, anywhere you'll go, they'll always, their name is Bolog's name. Yes, 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 your friend. Know him. So when he in 67, I came in contact with him, and I found him a very generous person, very friendly, and always helpful to the scientists. Was always wanted to see us with your dirty hands, not your clean hands. One thing with the his motto, that he wants to see no people die of hunger. How can we help them to produce more wheat? or more grains. And secondly, his concern was those who are working on the improvement of wheat, how can he help them? How can he share with, how can their use help, take my help and do good work? That was concern. That's why his doors were always open. His colleagues who were working with him in cement also, they were also of course, a helping hand. As a result of this, whatever good they have, we can share with them. He is my deepest friend. And I will say in wheat research, I gained a lot from him, who is always generous, who is also loving, and who also wants you to do work, not sit idle.
This Borlaug lag came up in 1987. This was a collaborative project with CIMIT on Karnalbant resistance, and it was under that project this lab came up here. And Punjab Agricultural University also has the distinction of recognizing and awarding Borlaug even before he got the Nobel Prize. He was awarded the degree of PhD honoris causa 1969 by PAU, one of the first institutes to do that. His gift goes beyond his dwarf wheats. He developed those wheats elsewhere in Mexico, and then he saw to it that he brought it to the farmers' fields here, moving through the these bureaucratic channels, working with the scientists, working with the farmers. He took it to where it was actually needed. The impact was that we moved from being a food deficit country to a food sufficient one.
It has been 50 years since the father of the Green Revolution first set foot in India. The humanitarian spirit of his work continues to this day through the efforts of the Borlaug Global Rust Initiative and the Durable Rust Resistance in Wheat Project. Norman E. Borlaug will be forever known as a visionary, a man who was a rebel, not with guns, but with plants. A man who worked tirelessly his entire life to benefit those less fortunate than himself. A man who believed that no child should go to bed hungry. As the next generation of hunger fighters marches forward into the fray, the legacy of Norman Borlaug's enduring devotion to the world's poor will continue to inspire all who work to create a world that is free from famine and poverty.